service is best first, and so we'll follow that order. We have service, of course, on Saturday and Sunday again. Otherwise, so let's begin with our opening hymn, Praise to the Lord the Almighty.
Thank you. praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you. Let the nations be glad and sing for joy. For you judge the peoples with equity, and guide the nations upon the earth. Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you. The earth has yielded its increase. God, our God, shall bless us. God shall bless us. Let all the ends of the earth fear him.
Please be seated for our hymn, and please rise for us. The second reading is from 1 Timothy chapter 2. First of all, then, I urge that supplications, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgivings be made for all people, for kings and all who are in high positions, that we may lead a peaceful and quiet life, godly and dignified in every way. This is good and is pleasing in the sight of God our Savior, who desires all people to be saved and to come to the knowledge of truth. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And the third reading is from Luke chapter 17. On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was passing along between Samaria and Galilee, and as he entered a village, he was met by 10 lepers who stood at a distance and lifted up their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priest." And as they went, they were cleansed. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice, and he fell on his face at Jesus' feet, giving him thanks. Now he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus answered, "Were not 10 cleansed? Where are the 9? Was no one found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner?" And he said to him, "Rise and go your way. Your faith has made you well." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Teach me your way, O Lord, that I may walk in your truth. Unite my heart to fear your name, that I may walk in your truth.
Taking time out, pausing and reflecting and what we are thankful for is a good discipline. And this evening offers us an opportunity to do that. Sometimes we need to think about what we might lose in order to be thankful for what we have. The scriptures remind us to give thanks. Everything that we have and need to support this body and life is a good gift from our Heavenly Father. The scripture reading for today comes from the epistle reading from 1 Timothy chapter 2, particularly this verse. I urge that supplications, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgivings be made for all people. We are included in all people. We can be prayed for, and we can pray for ourselves, just as we pray for others. Supplications, prayers, and intercessions is what Christians do when they are in need or when they see other people in need. First, we begin with the household of faith, and then we pray for the world in general. When we are in need, when there is trial and suffering upon us, it seems fairly easy for us to fall on our knees and pray, asking that God help us, asking that God would deliver us from whatever is troubling us. And it's not wrong for us to pray when we're in need. In fact, the Lord tells us to pray. And if anything, we do not pray enough. The Lord tells us to pray without ceasing. You see, our Lord wants us to call upon Him in prayer, praise, and thanksgiving. He wants us to do this all the time. In fact, the entire life of a Christian ends up becoming one prayer. So what should we pray for? We should pray for anything that we need to support our body and life. We pray for the things we need to support our lives. We pray to have a job or to keep our job or to find a job or to get a better job. We pray for our family, whatever the needs of our children or our parents or grandparents or our extended family. We pray for food. We pray for clothing. We pray for our house and home. We pray for our cars and transportation. Even our animals and livestock, we pray for. We pray for our health. We pray that the Lord deliver us from health concerns or heal us or give us the grace to accept what we are afflicted with. We pray for our family and our friends. We pray for our congregation and for the people within our congregation. And we pray for the church throughout the entire world. We pray for our government, even if we don't particularly like our government. We pray for our local officials, our state officials, and our federal officials. We pray for people in need around the world, especially after they have suffered a disaster or bad weather, a famine or a war. You see, when we pray the Lord's Prayer, we say, give us our daily bread. And when we pray that, we pray for everything that we need to support our body and life. There is nothing that we cannot bring to our Lord in prayer. When we pray, Lord, have mercy, we pray for the needs, we pray for our needs, the needs of our family, we pray for the needs of the world. If you hear of some tragedy in the world, and all you can say is, Lord, have mercy, that's all prayer you need right then. In Romans 8, verses 26 and 27, we hear, in the same way, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. We do not know what we ought to pray for, but the Spirit Himself intercedes for us through groanings that cannot be expressed. Our Lord even interprets our prayers in the best way. If we, in fact, pray wrongly or improperly, the Holy Spirit intercedes for us in our right way. If we don't have the words to pray because we're in pain or grief or agony, or maybe even lost our mind, the Holy Spirit intercedes on our behalf. And we also know from the scriptures that Jesus prays for us. How comforting it is to hear that our Lord prays for us, especially when we cannot pray for ourselves. And for that alone, we give thanks to our Lord. We give thanks that He prays for us. But we take a moment to consider our lives. We really have a lot to give thanks for. The life of a Christian is to be one of gratitude. First and foremost, we are thankful that our Lord has given us the gift of life. He has made us in His image. And more than that, our Lord has given us new life in Him through the waters of holy baptism. In baptism, we were buried with Christ in death, and we rise with Him again in life everlasting. We give thanks that our Lord has forgiven our sins. He has taken away our guilt. Now, some people today say that the modern person does not feel guilt so much. We aren't as much of a judgment society. Rather, we feel shame. Well, in Christ, we no longer need to be ashamed of anything, for He has taken our shame upon Himself. And we can give thanks to Jesus for this. We can never give our Lord enough thanks for what He has done for us. Now, when we think back over this past year, when we consider all that's happened, even from the beginning of the pandemic, we have a lot to be thankful for. Most of us, thus far, have been preserved from infection. Others of us have become infected but recovered, and we're thankful that the Lord has provided for our food and our shelter this past year. We're thankful for our family and friends. We're thankful that the Lord sends His holy angels to protect us each day. Every time you've had a near miss, the Lord sends angels to protect you. We give thanks for that. We're thankful for our church and for the ability to come and worship Him both in person and online. We're thankful for the saints who have gone before us, especially our dear loved ones, who are now with the Lord, enjoying His presence. And we're thankful that we will see them again. You see, there's so much for us to be thankful for. And if we start to think about everything we ought to be thankful for, the list goes on and on. It's nearly endless. So what do? As God's thankful people, we live lives of gratitude. We learn to be thankful in every situation and all circumstances, as St. Paul says. We can also pray that the Lord grant us a spirit of thankfulness and gratitude. By living thankful lives, we help others around us see the wonderful gifts of God. We help them see why we have hope in the midst of trouble. And as we grow in appreciation for all that our Lord has done for us, we can be thankful even in the difficult times, just like the hymn writer, "Now thank we all our God." Our Lord has forgiven our sins. He has called us to be His thankful people. He has given us our life, family, shelter, clothing, food, friends, animals, and church. He's given us all that we have. Let us be thankful and full of gratitude for all our Lord has done. Go in peace. Amen. Please rise for the painful.
Let my prayer rise before You as incense. Thank you.
Let us pray to the Lord with thanksgiving for all his blessings, and with trust in his mercy to hear and answer us. For the richness of his creation and for his grace to sustain what he has made, for the bounty of resources that sustain our daily lives, and for the good fruit of the earth by which we and all creatures are fed and nourished. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the government and order in our land and in the world, for those who lead us in this nation, and for all leaders of all nations, and for the blessing of justice, the protection of life, and the promotion of virtue. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For our life together as God's people in this place, for the church throughout all the world, for the missionaries planting new churches, and for our unity in doctrine and life. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For those who suffer illness of body or mind, for those who sorrow at the loss of those they love, for those in your death, and especially we remember those from our congregation, Bill and Carolyn, Connie, Diane, Kathy, Jason, Lula, Steve, Patience, Judy, Yvonne, Mary, Lyle, John, and Jerry. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For thankful hearts that we may not forget the poor and those in need, for generosity that we may supply from our abundance those in want, and for the tithes and offerings we bring in gratitude for all of God's gifts. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
In faithful remembrance of the saints who went before us, for grace to rejoice in the mercies the Lord has shown to them in their lives, and for the promised day of reunion, when the dead in Christ shall be raised, and we shall join them in everlasting life and light. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
In all things, O Lord, grant to us grace not to think more highly of ourselves than we ought, but to honor you above all, and to love our neighbors as ourselves. On our own, we have nothing that will endure, but you have granted to us all things in Christ and the life that does not end. Hear your people for the sake of and in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, with whom, in whom, and through whom all honor and glory is yours. Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.